गुड मॉर्निंग 10th क्लास. टुडे अवर चैप्टर इज चैप्टर नंबर 11, द ह्यूमन आई एंड द कलरफुल वर्ल्ड. इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टोटल ऑफ 6 टॉपिक्स. आउट ऑफ दिस टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील 11.4, डिस्पर्शन ऑफ वाइट लाइट बाय अ ग्लास प्रिज्म. So here is our topic. Dispersion is a new term for you. White light, that means we are using sunlight, and glass prism. A prism, you are already aware, and it is made up of glass. So look at this figure, beautiful figure. And a figure of, you can compare this figure with which color? From which phenomena? Rainbow, right? Very good. So here, this one is glass prism, written here, glass prism. And what is this? White light beam. White light beam, that means what we are using? We are using sunlight, okay? Sunlight is considered as white light beam. And here, all these are different colors of rainbow. It starts from V. V stands for violet, okay, beautiful colors, violet. Then there is indigo, then there is blue, sky blue is there, then green, yellow, orange, and then red is there. It is in the form of vibgyor, okay. The acronym used here is vibgyor. It is represented by different colors also. This will help you to memorize. Now here, once again, we are relating this diagram with our own phenomena. This band of colors is known as spectrum. Okay, one word is here. The band of colors is known as spectrum. And another term for you is dispersion. So white light is splitted into different colors. This is known as dispersion. Here we have a definition. Spectrum means the band of colored components of a light beam is called spectrum. And second is the splitting of light into its component color. So this one is the definition of dispersion. And what is the reason behind dispersion? So again, we are back on the same slide. Dispersion, you are observing here white light, and white light is incident light. Kaise pata chalega aapko ki incident hai? Because the arrow is moving towards the surface, lateral face, okay. And this medium is air, and this medium is, what is this? This is glass, okay. Prism is made up of glass, so the two media are different. Naturally, when incident ray fall on when incident ray falls on this face, there will be refraction to hoga hi. And white light is a combination of all these colors. When you combine all these color, what is formed? White light, right? So all these color, each color has its own wavelength. Aapne 9th class mein padha hai about wavelength, right? So each color has its own wavelength. When you mix all these color, which color is formed? White color, right? So here, white color is falling on this, white light beam is falling on this face, and when it moves in another medium, each wavelength has its own speed, right? So naturally their speed is variated. There is variation in their speed, and that causes deviation. Okay, the angle of incidence is different, right? This causes variation. So we are looking here about the reason. Different colors of light bend through different angles with respect to incident ray. So here, what we are doing here, incident ray, and here the refracted one. This one is refracted, this one is emergent ray. So incident ray, their angle of deviation is their angle of bending with respect to incident ray is different. That means angle of refraction is different. Understood? So if angle of refraction is different, naturally their emergent rays will be different. So here, as they passes through a prism, we are here. Then now, which color bends least? Red. And which was most? It is violet. So we are back again on the same slide. Which color is bending least? Okay, red. And which one is most? Violet. So this is all about dispersion. And next we have another figure for you. Just look here. What all are you observing? The two prism. Okay, you are observing two prism. One is erect, other one is inverted. Clear? And here white light, and here also white light. And just look here, white light, it breaks into all the seven colors. Upper one is red, and then the lower most is violet, and the same here, red and violet. But when it falls on another inverted prism, then red and violet, and at the end what you're observing, white light. So in the starting it is white, and here also it is white. That means when you allow white light to fall on a prism, it breaks into seven color. And again, when you allow all the seven colors to fall on another inverted prism, then again you will get a combination of all those seven colors, right? This is recombination of a spectrum of white light. Here splitting and here recombining, right? And this experiment, this erect and inverted phenomena, is given by Sir Isaac Newton, the famous personality, the famous scientist, was the first to use glass prism to obtain the spectrum of sunlight. Wo prism wala experiment kisne kiya tha? Sir Isaac Newton. Sabse pehle unhone perform kiya tha. White light break ho jati hai seven colors mein, aur again jab seven colors ko prism pe dalte hain to wapas se wo ek color ban jata hai, white light. So here his explanation is, he then placed a second identical prism in an inverted position with respect to first prism, allowed all colors of his spectrum to pass through the second prism. He found a beam of white light emerging from other side of the second prism. The same concept I have already explained, and this observation gave Newton the idea that sunlight is made up of seven color. So about the same backslide we are moving, what conclusion was drawn by Newton? The sunlight is made up of seven colors. Very good. And next we have now third and fourth figure. Just look here. 11.2, taken from your NCERT textbook. What are you observing here? The rainbow, right? The beautiful rainbow. Kab hota hai? Aapko kab milta hai? During the season, or during rainy season, right? You observe this rainbow. And here, this is about rainbow formation, and the principle or the reason behind science, right? So in view of science, rainbow is because of this sunlight. When falls on a raindrop, this one is water droplet, one water droplet, when sunlight falls on raindrop, clear? Then look here, this one is air and this is water. Very good. So there must be refraction. Refraction means this orange light will not move straight. There is refraction, bending of light, right? And here there is total internal reflection. It is reflection, okay, not refraction. It is reflection. Why it is reflection? Because same, it is moving back in the same medium. So here it is refraction, here it is total internal reflection, and here it is again refraction. So two refraction is occurring and one total internal reflection is occurring. And then you will observe red color upper and violet color below. Oh, here is observer, any person, okay, any persons. Then sun is backside, water is coming from here, then he will observe rainbow. Right, then related information is, a rainbow is a natural spectrum appearing in the sky after a rain shower. It's very easy. It is caused by dispersion of sunlight by tiny water droplets. Dispersion means splitting of sunlight into different colors. Okay, then the number third point is, a rainbow is always formed in a direction opposite to that of sun. Clear? Then number fourth is, the water droplet acts like a small prism. Okay, so here water droplet is acting as prism, that's why there is dispersion. They refract and disperse the incident sunlight, they then reflect it internally, that is total internal reflection, and finally refract it again when it comes out of the raindrop. Right, so all these concepts I have already explained you. Then next point is, due to dispersion of light and internal reflection, different colors reach the observer's eye. Next is, you can also see a raindrop on a sunny day when you look at the sky through waterfall or through a water fountain with the sun behind you. Just look here, the person, the sun, and here is means a formation of rainbow and the sun, they are opposite to each other, and sun is at the back of the person, right? And if there is sun, you can also observe rainbow, right? So all these concepts are now clear to you. Next is our new term. One new term is there that is not mentioned in your book, but you must have this knowledge with you. Total internal reflection. Just look here, this one is air and this one is water, okay? And here the incident ray is going from water to air, right? So this angle theta, right, incident ray, and here theta 2, Understood? And here is theta, and it is C. C represents critical angle, critical incident angle, right? So here incident ray is going, but it is moving on the same surface, on the surface interface of air and water. Dono ki beech mein move kar raha hai. राइट एंड जस्ट लुक हियर, ये छोटा है, छोटा एंगल है, ये थोड़ा सा बड़ा है, एंड हियर ये उससे भी बड़ा है. सो व्हेन इंसिडेंट एंगल इज मोर देन क्रिटिकल एंगल, इससे अगर बड़ा होता है, देन व्हाट हैपेंस, द रिफ्रैक्टेड रे इज मूविंग बैक इनटू द सेम मीडियम. दिस इज नोन एज टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. अंडरस्टूड? वंस अगेन हियर इंसिडेंट रे, right, it is moving in the other medium, but if incident ray is equal to critical angle, then it moves on the interface in between air and water. But if incident angle is more than critical angle, then refracted ray moves back in the same medium. Clear? This is known as total internal reflection. Reflection here is in the same medium. And this condition arises when incident ray moves from denser to rarer medium, not from here to here, right? It always moves from denser to rarer medium. So two conditions are required. One is the ray must moves from denser to rarer medium, and number second, the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. And the upper one is the definition of total internal reflection. Easy hoga aapke liye. It is complete reflection of a ray of light within a medium such as water or air from the surrounding surface back into the medium when the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. Clear? So this is all about today's topic, and assignment 4 is waiting for you. Question number 1 is define a spectrum and dispersion. Question number 2, name the color of light deviates most and least. Very easy for you through a prism. And one more additional is there, and give reason for the same also, why it deviates most or least. Question number 3 is who was the first person. So very easy for you. Number 4, what is the condition for observing rainbow on a sunny day. And number 5, define total internal reflection with 2 examples and 2 conditions. This is the end of today's video session. Aap complete karenge sara homework and today's assignment number 4 and submit in the group. Thank you.